Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to talk about how to get set up in Cartoon Animator 4's Motion Live 2D plugin with your Perception Neuron device. To get started, you'll need to download the Perception Neuron application from their website. Currently you can choose between the Studio, Pro, and 32 V1 and V2 versions of the hardware. All versions shown here are supported by the Motion 2D Live plugin. Noitum also has a tutorial page that contains a number of different tutorials to help you get set up with your hardware. Once you have all of the Noitum software set up, go to your settings in the main interface window in order to confirm the settings you're going to use to connect with the Motion Live 2D plugin. We're currently using the Studio version, and we'll show the Pro version right after this. First, you'll want to make sure that you have BVH turned on in order to broadcast the data in the correct format that the Motion Live 2D plugin can accept. Your protocol should be set to TCP, and make sure that you take note of your local IP address and port, because you will need this information in Cartoon Animator. This address will be unique to your local machine, so don't change it if you're only using a single computer. In the Pro version, not much is different except for the interface. You'll want to access the settings from the top menu, and in the General section you'll find your IP and port information. In the Broadcasting section, ensure that TCP is selected, and that you have BVH enabled as well. Finally, let's take a look at getting set up in Cartoon Animator 4. You can see the Perception Neuron interface in the background on the right. Let's go up to Plugins and open up the Motion Live 2D. From there, we can select the Perception Neuron under the Body section and ensure that the IP and port addresses are the same. We're using Studio for this example, so we'll quickly go into the settings just to make sure those are correct. From there, click the empty circle beside the Perception Neuron profile to start the connection. We also need to select it in the Hands section as well, since we're using Perception Neuron Studio, and we're going to be taking data from the hands. In the Character list, we need to also select it under the Body and Hand columns, since we'll be accepting data for both. In this case, you can see our motion capture in the background is running from side to side from a profile view. So, in order to recreate that in Cartoon Animator, we're going to select the side profile for the hands here. If we select the body column, some different settings will appear. Here, we also want to select a side profile. There is also an option for 45 degrees, but in this case, we're going to go for 90. It's recommended in some cases to enable position lock, but unlock the height. This will ensure that the character remains at the center of your viewport in Cartoon Animator, but its height and bouncing up and down will not be affected. After all that is finished, let's go ahead and give it a preview. You can see we get some great results translated into Cartoon Animator. Notice that the character is able to bounce up and down, but remains centered in the viewport due to our position lock. That's all there is to getting set up with your Perception Neuron in Cartoon Animator 4. As always, remember to check out our forums over at forum.reallusion.com, and I hope to see you in the next video.